Scientists can measure dinosaurs' temperatures thanks to a tough crystal-like mineral that accumulates in bones and teeth, known as bioapatite. Bioapatite contains mostly carbon and oxygen, but not all of those carbon and oxygen atoms are the same. Heavy isotopes, specifically C13 and O18, have a stronger attraction to each other than they do to the more common, lighter isotopes of carbon and oxygen. So when these atoms come together to form minerals, they don't stick together randomly. Instead, these heavy isotopes are more likely to end up bonded to each other than they otherwise would be by random chance. But if we crank up the heat, the heavy isotopes have less of a chance to bond with each other. So bones that form at warmer temperatures contain fewer bonds between heavy carbon and heavy oxygen than bones formed at cooler temperatures. Let me say that again. The fraction of bonded together heavy isotopes in a sample of bone can serve as a record of how warm or cool the bone was when it formed. It's not sticking a thermometer under a dinosaur's tongue, but it might be the next best thing. And that's how we know that T. rex had a body temperature of 38 degrees Celsius.